Welcome back to Marshall University Stadium. At the half, Marshall leads Western Michigan 13-0. Just 2 weeks ago, a memorial was dedicated outside the stadium, words engraved in bronze that read, "A gift from our hearts that has healed our hearts." You see, some 30 years ago, a plane carrying the Marshall University football team, coaches, and fans home from a game against East Carolina crashed. All 75 people on board perished in one of sport's most devastating tragedies. The pain is endured to this day. Visible remembrances are everywhere. For example, 75 flags, one for each person lost, line the boulevard that runs from the stadium to the cemetery. One player who missed that fateful flight was co-captain Nate Ruffin, who stayed behind in Huntington because of an injury. Nate has been instrumental since then in carrying on their legacy. To mark this year's anniversary, he put his thoughts down on paper in an open letter to his departed friends.
Dear guys, I know you don't keep time up there, but I promise you it's 2000. And everybody's still making a big deal about each of you. You remember when you guys thought that Marshall's worst news ever was the recruiting scandal of 1969? Well, boys, I have some news for you. It's been surfaced and said that the biggest news now is the November 14th plane crash, which you guys were a part of. I waited for you guys, by the way, at the Keith Albee Theater to see if you guys had won the game, but the crash postponed our meeting. People cried for nights and days, and we identified all but six of you. But we know who you were, and so you are remembered also. Just like our dream was to be winners, the teams that followed you guys were very heroic. Against great odds, they lost every season until 1984. And then in 1987, they went to the national championship in Pocatello, Idaho. I even hitchhiked. Guys, you know I probably could have gotten the money from somewhere, but all the flights were filled. We lost the game, by the way, but thousands of diehard Herd fans witnessed the scene, and I know you guys saw it too. By the way, there are a lot of people remembering you in a lot of different ways. Old Sharkey Student Union was renamed in honor of you. You all remember that place, but now you'd never recognize it. It has a big tulip in front of it. And each one of the little heads on top of it represents one of you. It's a fountain, they say, but people come from all over every November 14th and remember you. For a while, I wished I were with you guys, but I realize now, many years later, that I was left here to keep your memory alive. As I close my letter, you know you guys helped me get a blessing from the guy in charge. I'm a grandpa and have three children. Finally, I have a personal problem of my own I want to talk to you about. I have colon cancer and am about to be treated for leukemia. But the big coach in the sky hasn't called me yet. If we need you guys on Saturday, we hope we can depend on you because you're always our 12th man. Co-captain Nate Ruffin.